Tuesday, 26th December, 1665. Up and to the office, where Sir James, Minnis, and my Lord Bruckner and I met to give our directions to the commanders of all the ships in the river to bring in lists of their ships' companies with entries, discharges, etc. And all last voyage where young Seymour, among 20 that stood bare, stood with his hat on, a proud, saucy young man. There and thence with them to Mr. Cuttle's, being invited and dined nobly and neatly with a very pretty house and a fine turret at the top, with winding stairs, and the finest prospect I know about all Greenwich, save the top of the top. Top of the hill. And yet, in some respects, better than that. Here, I also saw some fine writing work and flourishing of Mr. Hoare. The one that I knew long ago, an acquaintance of Mr. Thompson's cat, Mr. Thompson's at Westminster, that is this man's clerk. It is the story of the several archbishops of Canterbury engrossed in vellum to hang up in Canterbury Cathedral in tables in lieu of the old ones, which are almost worn out. Thence to the office a while, and so to Captain Cox, and there talked, and home to look over my papers, and Facebook post, and so to bed. Wednesday, 27th December, 1665. Up and with cock by coach to London. There, home to my wife, and angry about her desiring a maid yet, before the plague is quite over. It seems Mercer is troubled that she hath not one under her, but I will not venture my family by encarcassing it before it be safe. Thence about many businesses, particularly with Sir W. Warren on the change, and he and I dined, and I dined together, settled out our Tangier matters, wherein I get above £200 presently. We dined together at the Pope's Head to do this, and thence to the goldsmith's, I to examine the state of my matters thereto. And so, with him to my house, but my wife was gone abroad to Mrs. Mercer's, and so we took a boat, and it being dark, and the thaw having broke the ice, but not carried it quite away, the boat did pass through much of it all along, and that, with the crackling and noise that it made, me fearful indeed. So I forced the waterman to land us on Redriff side. And so I walked together till Sir W. Warren and I parted near his house. And thence I walked quite over the fields home, by light of the link, one of my many watermen carrying it, and I reading by the light of it, it being a very fine, clear, dry night. So to Captain Cox, and there sat and talked, especially with his counsellor, about his prize goods that hath done him good tune, being of the company with Captain Fisher, his name Goddison. Here I supped, and so home to bed, with great content that the plague is decreased to 152, the whole being but 330. Thursday, 28 December, 1665. Up and to the office, thence, with a great deal of business in my head, dined alone with Cock, so home alone, strictly about my accounts, wherein I made a good beginning. And so, after letters wrote by the post, to bed. December 1665. Up betimes, and all day long within doors, upon my accounts, public and private, and find the ill effect of letting them go so long without evening, that no soul could have ever understood them but myself, nor my accountant. And I wish much, with much, and I, with much ado. But However, my regularity in all I did and spent do help me, and I hope to find them well, late at them, and to bed. Saturday, 30 December, 1665. Up and to the office, at noon, home to dinner, and all the afternoon to my accounts again. And there, find myself, to my great joy, a great deal worth above £4,000. For which the Lord be praised, and is principally occasioned to my getting £500 of Cock for my profit in his bargains of prize goods, and from Mr. Gordon's making me a percent of £500 more when I paid him £8,000 for Tangier. So to my office to write letters, and then to my accounts again, and so to bed, being in great ease of mind. Sunday, 31 December, 1665, Lord's Day. All morning, in my chamber, writing fair the state of my Tangier accounts, and so dined at home. In the afternoon, the Duke of Albemarle, and thence back again by water, and so to my chamber to finish the entry of my accounts, and to think of the business I am next to do, which is the stating of my thoughts and putting in order my collections about the business of purses, to see where the fault of our present constitution relating to them lies, and what to purpose to mend it. And upon this late, and with my head full of this business, to bed. Thus ends this year, to my great joy, in this manner. I have raised my estate from £1,300 in this year to £4,400. I've got myself greater interest, I think, by my diligence, and my employments increased by that of treasurer for Tangier and surveyor of the victuals. It is true, we've gone through great melancholy because of the great plague, and I put great charges by it, by keeping my family long at Woolwich, and myself, and another part of my family, my clerks, at my charge at Greenwich, and made at London. But I hope the King will give us some satisfaction for that. But for now, the plague is abated almost, and I, intending to get to London as fast as I can, my family, that is my wife and maids, having been there these 2 or 3 weeks. The Dutch war goes on very ill by reason of lack of money. Having none to hope for, all being put into disorder by a new act that is made as an experiment to bring credit to the exchequer for goods and money to be advanced upon the credit of that act. I have never lived so merrily. Besides that I never got so much as I have done this plague time by my Lord Broncos and Captain Cox's good company and the acquaintances of Mrs. Knip Coleman and her husband and Mr. Lanier and great store of dancings we have had at my cost, which I was willing to indulge myself and wife at my lodgings. The great evil of this year, and the only one indeed, is the fall of my Lord of Sandwich, whose mistake about the prizes hath undone him, I believe, as to interest the court. Though sent, for a little palliating it, ambassador into Spain, which he is now fitting himself for. But the Duke of Albemarle goes with the prince to sea this next year, and my lord very meanly spoken of, and indeed his miscarriage about the prize goods is not to be excused, to suffer a company of rogues to go away with 10 times as much as himself, and the blame of all to be deservedly laid upon him. My whole family hath been well all this while, and all my friends I know of, saving my Aunt Belle, who is dead, and some children of my cousin Sarah's, of the plague. But many of such as I know very well, dead. Yet to our great joy the town fills apace, and shops begin to open again. Pray God continue the plague's decrease, for that keeps the court away from the place of business. And so all goes to rack. As to public matters, they, at this distance, not thinking of it. And to you, my subscribers, my friends, and those watching this video, I wish you a very happy, prosperous new year. May the sun shine on you and your loved ones. May you be kind to others. May you be good to yourself. May good things happen to you. And by little things that you can do, such as a kindness, help, a smile to others and to yourself. The small choices we make every day to do the good and the right thing. Up here, in here, Happy New Year. I look forward to seeing you in the new year. Many blessings.